Hello everyone, Assalamu alaikum, welcome back to Dr. Teeth. In this video, we are going to talk about dentin. Now, this chapter will be covered in multiple videos. And in this video, we are going to talk about the physical properties and the chemical properties of dentin. So let's get started. Now, dentin makes up the bulk of the tissue. So here in this image, all this area, which is in skin color, is the dentin. This in light yellow is the enamel, and this in red is the pulp, right? So as you can see here, dentin makes up the bulk of the tooth. And if you look closely at this dentin, you will find that we have various tubules in the dentin, okay? These are the dentinal tubules. And it is present all throughout the dentin. Now, dentin determines the shape of the crown. So, it makes up the shape of the cusp. It also determines the number of roots. Now, if you look closely at the tubules, you will find that we have the processes of cells, which are the odontoblasts. So, if you look closely, we have processes of the cell. These cells are known as the odontoblast. These are the specialized cells. Now, if you look at odontoblast and you compare it with bone, they are physically and chemically similar. Outside the bone, the cells which are there, they are known as osteoblast. And when one of these goes inside and gets enclosed within the matrix, that is known as the osteocyte. However, in case of dentin, the cell body of odontoblast, it is outside the dentin, as you can see here. Okay, it is outside the dentin. But their processes, these extensions, they go within the dentinal tubules. Let's come to the physical and the chemical properties of dentin. Now, if you compare a young child's teeth with an old age teeth, you will find that the color has become slightly more yellow in this case. So dentin is slightly yellowish, but the yellowish color deepens with age. So you'll find old age people having more yellow teeth. Dentin is viscoelastic, unlike the enamel, which was hard and brittle. It is somewhat harder than bone. But it is softer than enamel. Okay, it is softer than enamel, right? But it is harder than bone, somewhat harder than bone. And the hardness varies even within the dentin. That means, if you come back to this image, the crown dentin and the root dentin hardness will vary. Also, the hardness in the center of the dentin will be more compared to that at the periphery and also at the bottom. Now coming back, dentin has a low mineral salt. It has 65% mineral salt, while enamel has around 90% mineral salt. That is why dentin is more radiolucent than enamel. So if you look at a radiograph, if you take a IOPA of a patient, you will find that the enamel looks very white, while the dentin looks a little less white, okay, in the X-ray. Let's talk about the composition. Dentin has organic material, which is 35%, and inorganic material, which is 65%. Now, in the organic material, we have the pink color right here. This is the ground substance, and in that, we have various fibrils. These are collagenous fibrils. Basically, type 1 collagen is the principal collagen which is found in dentin. Now, the ground substance is made up of mucopolysaccharides, which is basically proteoglycans and glycosaminoglycans. And this ground substance has proteoglycans, chondroitin sulfates, decorin and biglycan, DSP, which is glycoproteins, dentin, siloprotein, DPP, which is phosphoprotein, dentin, phosphoprotein, GLA proteins, which is gamma carboxyglutamate containing protein and phospholipid. Apart from this, we also have various growth factors. Now, these growth factors, we have the transforming growth factor, which is the TGF. We have the fibroblast growth factor, which is the FGF. We have the insulin-like growth factor, which is the IGF. We have the platelet-derived growth factor, which is PDGF. Placenta growth factor, which is PEGF. Vascular endothelial growth factor, which is VEGF. And angiogenic growth factor, which is AGF. So many growth factors are there. And as already told, we have the type 1 collagen as the principal type of collagen. Coming to the inorganic material. Inorganic material basically has hydroxyapatite, which is similar to what is found in bone, enamel, as well as cementum. Now, each hydroxyapatite crystal, they have several thousand unit cells. And these unit cells have this formula, which you have to remember. Also remember that these unit cells are smaller than the hydroxyapatite crystals which were found in enamel. Apart from this, we have small amount of phosphates, carbonates and sulfate. These crystals are poor in calcium, but they are rich in carbon when we compare them to enamel. Now, one viable question for you. When we decalcify the tooth in ground section, why is enamel lost? Think for a while. And the answer is, since we have only 65% inorganic material compared to the 90% in the enamel, only 65% of it is lost. So 35% of the organic material remains, which maintains the shape of dentin, and it helps in having a clear histological view. On the other hand, enamel has majority of the inorganic material. So during decalcification, most of it is lost. That is why enamel is lost after decalcification. So with this, we complete the physical and the chemical properties of dentin. I have taken reference from Orban's. It is a very standard book and you should all read it. Also, you can check out more videos on our app, and notes related to this video will also be made available on our app. So if you like the video, please do subscribe to my channel. Till we meet next time, take care and have a good day.